So far you have seen how well some indicators such as the moving averages work in the trading market. However, these indicators are not so useful in trading ranges. What you could use instead are the oscillators. These are said to be the leading indicators as opposed to the lagging indicators, which is what moving averages are and tend to lag in the trend. So we have two types of indicators. We have indicators that are located on the charts or that are particularly with the candles. Okay? They are displayed on the candles, indicators such as the moving averages. When you look at the moving averages are normally with the candles. You get it? Such indicators are known as the lagging indicators. We also have other indicators such as the Bollinger Bands. When you look at the Bollinger Bands, the Bollinger Bands basically show you the parameters overbought, oversold conditions, yes, with a deviation in between. But when market reaches the lower band, you expect the market going what? Up. When it reaches the upper band, you expect the market to go where? Down. So they show you oversold, overbought conditions. Such indicators are known as the lagging indicators. We have indicators such as the oscillators. These momentum indicators are basically to show you the stand in the market. They show you what we expect in the near future. You get it? So that's why they are so-called the leading indicators. So the leading indicators are basically the ones that I want us to look at today. One of which is the RSI. We have also the ADX. We have the stochastic. We have MACD. Who knows any of the oscillators that we have that has come up close? We have the MACD. I've mentioned the MACD. The ADX. I've mentioned that. ATR. There are so many. They are important. Okay. At least each one of you must have come across any of these indicators. So even when you don't know how to trade, but with these indicators, they'll help to tell you that, you know what, man, apparently where the market is we expect it to go where? Apparently where the market is, we expect it to go where?
Down.
You get it? So you don't necessarily need to know technical analysis, because this will basically help to show you that now the market is going up, is going down. Unlike the moving averages which are plotted on the chart, oscillators are plotted below the price charts. So you realize that the leading indicators of the RSI, sorry, or the stochastics are normally displayed below the what? Below the chart. If this is your chart, okay, the candles are here. Normally for them they are indicated where? Down. Some people will say that they are actually volumes. Before you start trading, you'll be like, these are showing volumes. Of course, you know, when it is up here, you know that it's coming well. That when it's here, you know that it's coming well. When it's up here, you know that it's coming down. An example is there. So they are normally plotted downwards, okay? So most indicators look alike and they are interpreted in the same way. Oscillators, indicators are bound within a range, usually between 0 and 100. This range is divided into upper and lower halves by the middle line, which is sometimes called the middle line, depending on the formula used to construct the oscillator. Remember that oscillators are secondary indicators and should not be used exclusively, but should be supported by other indicators as well. You should always look at the prices on the chart before and whether the overall trend supports the idea. So before you can trade with the oscillators, you need to put this in your mind that when you're trading with the oscillators or when you're trading with these indicators, that they are secondary indicators. In other words, they are not primary indicators. Secondary indicators, it means that they are working with the other indicators or other instruments for you to be in position to trade with them. They are not a standalone systems. Okay? So don't use them alone. They are simply a confirmation of any analysis. That if I'm using the Fibonacci is telling me that market has reached the bouncing point. Are we together? If it has reached the bouncing point, then what is the oscillator telling me? Is it also speaking the same language? Is it also telling me that now the market is expected to go up, having the Fibonacci reached a Fibonacci level, or the Fibo levels, right? So they are basically secondary indicators. Okay? The uses of oscillators. The oscillators, some of their importances are basically to show a loss in momentum. Indicators, if we are popular and katakatale, we can lose the momentum, okay? Or it has gained momentum. When market loses momentum, what do you normally expect, you as traders? If it loses momentum, it means that now it has been oversold. Okay? We have two conditions in the market. We have the overbought and the oversold condition. Overbought condition means that the market has been overbought. Therefore, we expect to sell it. It has reached its climax upwards. So we expect to sell this market. Are we together? So it means that the market has gained momentum. Therefore, it's about to lose momentum. Therefore, we should buy it. Are we together? So we have, normally these indicators work in the range, and they literally look the same way, but interpreted in a different way. They are the same, they work in the ranges between 0 and 100. Okay? And interpreted the same way, but they have different attributes. When you look at the MACD, moving average, convergence, divergence, okay? The way it's looking is literally not the same as the RSI. Both of these have different attributes, but can be interpreted in the same way because they all work with overbought, oversold conditions or territories. If it's the stochastic, okay? You realize that for it to move like this, and when you see the stochastic itself moving like this, it normally means that now you expect to do what? You expect to do what? When it reaches here, you do what? When it comes down here, it means that you do what? You do what? Then you repetitively keep on doing the same thing. Okay? So, this region here, normally when you look at the stochastic, it's normally listed 20, 30. Actually, I think it's 20. This is 80. Are you together? This region is called the region where before, below 20 and 0 is not, it's called the over what? The oversold? The oversold region. This is the oversold region or territory. Then this is the over what? Are we together? So they're actually showing you that now you should buy, or you should do what? You should sell. Because they show all their indicators, they indicate where they are apparently they stand in the market, okay? They are an indication that you should buy, you should sell. But remember, when you're using this, they should work as secondary. You should need, you have to be in position to know that if I'm working with these oscillators, these indicators, I'm supposed to use them with something else, with another tool. Are we together? Such as you can use it with the Fibonacci, you can use it with the trend lines, you can use it with the Bollinger Bands, you can use it with the moving averages, and so on and so forth. In other words, you should not use this alone. Hello? You should not use this
alone.
We can say, oh, we can use the oscillators to spot any divergence from the price direction. This is an important warning that the price has changed. Quote, change. Divergence only applies. So, there is what we call divergence in the market. What is divergence? Divergence means that as the candles are moving upwards, this oscillator or this indicator, for it is showing a downward movement. Are you together? But when you look at the candles will be moving in an up direction. So there is a divergence between a miscommunication between these two, the market and the oscillator or this indicator. Okay? So We take also an opportunity, however much the market is speaking the language, the different language as compared to that of the market, we can also take an action. We have an important opportunity here that if the market is moving in a different direction and the oscillator is moving in a different direction, we normally take the direction of the oscillator. If the oscillator is moving down, okay, and the indicator is moving, sorry, and the market is moving up, therefore we normally take the direction of the what?
Oscillator.
Of the oscillator. If the oscillator is moving down, are we together? That is called a negative divergence, because the oscillator will be moving down and the market will be going where? Above. So it means that if you are buying this market, it's high time for you to come out in this market, out of this market, because the oscillator is a leading indicator. In other words, it is showing you peace. This indicator is showing you what you're expecting because it's a leading indicator. Therefore, you take the direction of the indicator. So if the indicator is moving downwards, it means that you should take the direction of the indicator. Then that automatically comes to be the negative divergence. So if the indicator is moving up and the market is moving where? It means that we call that a positive divergence. Therefore, take the direction of the indicator because it's a leading indicator. Okay? An example is displayed here. You see? This is an example. As this market is moving downwards, okay? This oscillator is moving where? Up. So this becomes a positive what? It is a positive divergence. So it means that if you have been selling the market, it means that now you come out of this market and enter in for what? Yes, please.
You say that we can't depend on oscillator because it's not the money. Now you are saying the oscillator is going up, the market and oscillator is following the oscillator, so I think it's there.
Okay. There are situations whereby you realize that the Fibonacci is telling you that the market is going where? Up. Are we together? Okay? It's going up, but literally it's a bit going where? Down. It's expected to bounce off. You get it? So for an indicator, for it to show you directly that it is already where? In an uptrend. Are we together? Meaning the market is only going to redress to that point for it to go up. So the indicator is already showing you what is expected to come. So that's why we say that when the market is moving down and the oscillator is moving up, you should just take the direction of the what? Of the oscillator. Don't get confused. Oscillators are indicators. Are you together? Because, but the oscillator is just a specific name given to the indicators that are normally below or that work in the ranges. Are we together? Whereas indicators that work when the markets are trending, you just call them indicators. Are we together? Okay? Or you can just say leading indicators, lagging indicators. Moving averages are indicators, but they are lagging indicators. So you can't call a moving average an oscillator. Oscillators normally work between ranges. Are you together? Like a pendulum, eh? Who knows what a pendulum is? Are you together? They just oscillate. A pendulum is oscillating. Are you together? So they are working within ranges. Oscillators is just a generic term, just like the way you see the word fruits which encompasses the mangoes, oranges, and blah blah, bears, pears, and so on and so forth. Not bears, but pears. Are you together? Guavas and all. So indicators is just a generic word that encompasses all the individual indicators, okay? Although the principle of interpretation applies to all of them, each indicator has a different attribute. You shall learn later, for instance, that the RSI lifts itself from the line construction, so does the stochastic, but it is not how it is normally interpreted. So they have the same attributes, they have different attributes, but different are the same attributes, but interpreted in a different way, okay? So you realize that the RSI lifts itself from the trend line construction, but so does the stochastic, but that's not how it is normally interpreted. Now we can move on to examine the following momentum indicators separately. So, just like I've told you, we have a couple of individual momentum indicators such as the RSI, the moving average, which is convergence and divergence. RSI stands for relative strength index. We have the momentum itself, which is price rock, the stochastic, and commodity channel index, that is the CCI. So let's look at individually the RSI. The RSI stands for relative strength index. So where do we get these indicators first and foremost? So let's first go to our charts. Get to your charts, okay? Are we all there?
Yes.
Get to your charts. This is where there is the indicators list.
Yes.
You go where there is indicators list. Look for the RSI. So we go here where there is indicators list. For those that can't tell where we get the indicators list, it's at this point. When you look there, you look for the oscillators, because the RSI is a subdivision or falls under the oscillators. Then look for the RSI, which is relative strength index, which is down here. It is exactly this one. Are we together?
Yeah.
So you put the RSI, click on it. When you click on it, it will bring out the parameters for you to change with exact parameters. Let's leave all the parameters by default. Are we together? Just don't change anything. Are we together? Just press OK. When you press OK, this is how it looks like. Let me first remove this. This is how it looks like. Actually, it's in a range between 0 to 100, but the oversold condition is between 0 and what? And 30. Then oversold is between 100 and 70. Are we together? So you realize at this point here, what would you do if this market came like this? Remember, I've told you. Are we all there? Have we put it there? It just looks like this. It's a line that is moving within ranges. In other words, it's like a line graph. Are you feeling that? Drawn down, down. Are you together? So it's more of a line that actually is displaying or representing whatsoever that is up there. Okay? The only advantage with it, it will be literally be like showing you the future. Are you together? It empiles or it entails all the data that is above, because when you look at it, it's just like a shadow. Are you together? Or maybe it's like a line graph, okay? So it's just down here. The good thing for it is that for it, it will show you the near future. Are you together? So it's telling you that the future is here. Are you together? We expect this market to still come here. You get it? So you see, the market is a bit lagged and this one is a bit in front. That's why it's called a leading indicator. And you're not supposed to buy or you're not supposed to sell, okay, for just a matter of this market reaching here and goes up. No, you're only supposed to buy or you're only supposed to sell when this market crosses this 70 line. Which one?
30
line, sorry. When it crosses it here, it goes down, you wait for it. Not until it comes what? When it comes out and it's about to cross it again, this is when you're supposed to do what? To buy. And when you buy, it goes where? We all see clearly that it went where?
Above.
And when the future is here, that's when you are supposed to get out of the market. And automatically, when you look at the highest point, which is this, this is the path this market has moved as part of this movement. Hello? Are we all there?
Yes.
So apparently, if you were to analyze based upon the RSI, would we do anything there to that market? What would you do as traders according to the current stand in the market? You do what? You wait. So you wait for it until it reaches either the oversold, overbought territories. And the most mistake most of the traders do, people that are trading are learning to trade do, is basically to put as many oscillators, many indicators, such that they also themselves get disorganized. You run mad. You find someone putting the MACD there, putting the Chimoko King Ohio, he's putting the MACD, he's putting the stochastic, he's putting the RSI, he's putting the moving averages. You get it? You run mad. Because the moving average will tell you that the market is going up, this will tell you that the market is going down. This will be telling you wait. So what would you do? Would you wait, would you buy, would you sell? You're just getting confused, eh?
Confused.
Are you together? So if you're to master trading, it's upon you to either decide to trade with, at least I encourage you to, if you use many indicators, you use at least, okay, maximum of three. So that's how the RSI works. You don't need to know more about the RSI.
Does this mean which time frames?
I would encourage you, if you're trading with the RSI, to actually trade it in relatively time frames, that is from 1 hour and below.
Shorter time frames.
Why? When you look at this, this is 1 hour. Eh? There are a few cases where it will tell you to buy or to sell. Eh? You get to see this. Eh? This is the time frame of 1 hour. But you realize that when you put it in 30 minutes or 5 minutes, you're getting more opportunities for you to buy and do items.